Star 101.3. Marcus and Corey just gave up more tickets for the Chicks. What's up to Vicky and Gilroy?
It's time for good news with Marcus and Corey.
Go, run, go.
Sometimes all you need is one good thought to make it a great day. So let's do this. It's good news on Star 101.3.
I like that little Friday sound effect you just did. What was that? That's what mine's at.
Yeah.
Give me some good news. What do you got?
We've been talking about this whole situation with the geese in Foster City.
Yes.
And trying to save them because the plan for the city is just murder 100 of them in a horrible, horrible way.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to help out and help us save the geese, please go to the Corey and Marcus Facebook page or the Marcus and Corey Facebook page. I didn't mean to put
myself
first.
Go to either one.
But this
everybody
is
knows who the star of the show is, okay?
Oh,
I'm just over here hitting.
Please. This is another story about birds. Traffic on 405 near Seattle came to a complete stop because a family of ducks were in the middle of this busy highway.
Aww.
So some really nice people stopped, got out of their cars, and blocked three lanes of traffic and quickly went to work making sure that the ducks got to the side of the road.
That's a busy freeway.
I know.
I'm not sure I would do all that if I'm being honest.
But I think the fact that three different cars stopped.
I suppose, yeah.
And it was only like a 10-minute delay.
Okay.
Because I've seen on the road, mm-hmm. And it's like I haven't had the chance to get out. There was no place to get out, so I worked. And the Washington State Department of Transportation, they tweeted that the duck family was moved safely off the highway and everybody was okay.
That's good.
I mean, animals.
I know how you feel about
their world.
I understand.
And, it's like we've built highways and they're like, man, I got to get to the lake. You guys put a highway here.
So a big one, too.
I appreciate when people take the time to help the animals.
That is good news. My good news is personal. Just a quick update on my torn rotator cuff rehab. We're in week 7 post-surgery, and for the first time ever this morning, I was able to apply deodorant to both pits, Corey.
Thank God.
And that is the update.
I mean, the good news for me is that you have deodorant.
I haven't been able to move my right shoulder for weeks. Do you know how frustrating it is not to be able to reach with my deodorant? To have my wife help me apply.
But at least you're doing it.
But now,
thank you.
As of this morning, for you. And we're going on the road this afternoon to talk to Joe Coy in Daly City. That's going to be a good. So I had to.
Fresh.
I've been doing my left pit forever. And now I can do them both. I'm a man again.
You're a big boy.
I'm a big boy.
Yeah, it's the little things.
Shoulder surgery knows what I'm talking about. 7:43. We're going to check what's trending coming up next.
So, the latest Bond girl from mm-hmm. No Time to Die, she has a very strong opinion about who the next Bond should be.
Okay. Getting to that and more coming up.
You're out of sight. Show me how you.
star 101.3.
All the times that you rain on my parade, and all the clubs you get in using my name. You think you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well I ain't. And I didn't wanna write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby I'll be moving on. And I think it should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on. But now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. When you told me that you hated my friends, the only problem was with you and not them. And every time you told me my opinion was wrong, you tried to make me forget where I came from. Didn't wanna write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, baby, I'll be moving on. And I think it should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on. But now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. All the times that you made me feel small, I fell in love, now I feel nothing at all. I never felt so low when I was vulnerable. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself.
More variety from the 2000s, the 90s, and today. Star 101.3. It's Friday. It's Marcus and Corey. Good morning.
This is what I'm talking about. It's what's trending on Star 101.3.
What's happening in entertainment news? The biggest stories of the day and everything people are talking about today in the Bay.
Trending is brought to you by Squeeze.com. Order yours today. Mr. and Mrs. Ben Affleck living in Paris.
You stop.
Oh no, they were caught walking in Paris yesterday. They're holding hands, and it's the first trip since they tied the knot over the weekend. And of course, they looked camera ready. You know, she's wearing this stunning red dress, and he's in a suit. And then, there's some casual shots too.
Sure.
But they do have a team of security with them, of course.
That's cute.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's probably one of the most famous couples right now.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see No Time to Die?
I saw half of it.
I did too. I fell asleep.
I was watching it with the old man, and I looked over, and he was asleep, and then I was like, I'm gonna finish this later.
Yeah.
It starts out pretty good.
No, it's great, mm-hmm. But I watched it on, like, a Friday night. And- So the Bond girl in No Time to Die, Ana de Armas, I hope I'm saying that right, she is talking about the James Bond debate on making the next James Bond a female. Mm-hmm. And I agree with her. She says no need. There shouldn't be any need to steal someone else's character, you know, take over. What they should do is have meatier roles in the Bond films for women.
Yes.
Make them as equal as Bond.
100%.
And I totally agree with that, because the allure of Bond is his charisma, you know?
I agree with that.
His charm and his sexy appeal.
His je ne sais quoi.
Exactly. Disney Plus is now going to have some R-rated movies. I was kind of surprised by this. They're going to get Deadpool, Deadpool 2, and Logan, which is the, you know, Logan is
Wolverine.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
My brain just stopped.
That was a live brain fart, you guys.
It was literally like brain.
You heard it here first.
You could hear the...
Watched it explode.
Stop. So, yeah, so Disney bought those, and those are going to be the first R-rated movies on Disney Plus.
That's awesome. Let's see, what's going down today? So, if you're looking for something to do this afternoon, Thrive City is going to be popping. This is at Chase Center, live music, food, and such at 6 o'clock. This is literally just for the community, and we had the privilege of interviewing one of the bands that are going to be performing tonight. This is the Curtis Family C-Notes. You might have seen them on America's Got
Sweet.
Are they not? God.
It's so nice. And you can learn more about them at 1013.com.
They're straight out of Hunter's Point. You can watch the interview at 1013.com. Go to the Marcus and Corey Instagram. I don't want to call them costumes, because I feel their style is so awesome. It's
yeah.
Like, think Earth, Wind, and Fire, Sly and the Family Stone. And they're so great. The kids are involved. Mom and Dad are all involved. And like
five
I said,
kids.
They made it to the quarterfinals of America's Got Talent City tonight. So if you're coming through, it's going to be a good time.
Yeah.
We've got live music. They've got food. They've got everything else going on. This is down at Chase Center. Starts off at 6 o'clock. So just for something to do today, maybe with the family. They just released the list of the highest paid actors in Hollywood. Tom Cruise getting paid. Now, he only made about 12 to 14 mil for Top Gun, but he also gets a... Jason, were you here for this last hour? You want to hazard a guess at how much money Tom Cruise has made off of Top Gun Maverick thus far?
I don't know. 200 million.
100 million.
100 million.
Still a lot of money.
That's a ton of money.
So he was the highest paid actor this year.
I'll take it.
Will Smith came in number two. He made 1 million for Emancipation. The highest paid female actor was Margot Robbie, who made 12 mil for Barbie.
That's nothing.
This is...
nothing.
Can we be better as a society, please?
I mean, there are so many amazing female actresses out there. Come on.
I thought this was interesting, though. There was a studio executive who said, most actors are not worth what we pay them, besides maybe Tom Cruise and maybe Dwayne Johnson.
Where's a woman in there? Meryl Streep.
Are you shocked?
Helen Mirren.
I find those lists that come out every now and then interesting, where it's like, here's the best value actor, like, for what they make versus what they're paid.
What they're paid, what the movie grosses. That's the one I gotta find.
That's ew.
Let's see, it's Furry Fridays today, and we have teamed up with Muttville Senior Dog Rescue. We talked about last hour, this hour, Avocado. The biggest lover girl of all time. Shy at first, but once you make friends, you're gonna be friends for life. She is so cute.
She looks like she's got some chihuahua in her.
These are all senior dogs. If you want to get adoption information, check out the pictures. And adopt, don't shop, go to 1013.com/furry friday.
Guess what's trending every weekday morning on the 50s? That's at 6:50, 7:50, and 8:50 a.m.
And connect now with the Marcus and Corey socials and blog. That's at 1013.com.
All right, we got some stuff up for grabs right now, but you got to call our trivia game, what you know about that.
800-800-1013.
We're looking for two contestants, and we're going to play at 8:05. Kate Bush running up that hill, Star Wars.